people who do have somewhat of an articulated spirituality certainly enables them to die in peace. However that's defined for them. The people who are surrounded by love, really, you know, it's so simple, and yet it's amazing how it's not so simple. But people who are surrounded by love, and I remember this one man who, he had a cancer and a tumor on the whole side of his face, bandaged right up. And it took me some time to sit with him, to simply be able to sit with him in peace. And so we sat for a while, and then we started. He was so surrounded by love with his family. It was evident everywhere, and he was an active participant in his family's life until he died. The person still had a voice, right? It wasn't, we want to be very helpful and do everything we can for another, and yet it's important that the other can have their voice still. And that voice might simply be that, hey, I have a future still. Hear me, you know? It could simply be that. My work is mostly within the context of a hospital system, right? So when a person comes into the hospital, then they come into a neutral ground, which can be very helpful for families, because whatever patterns have been created over the years, somehow it's being interfered with by their loved one being in a hospital. So that actually helps sometimes. I listen, right? Try to get an understanding. Try to hear what it is that the family member wants. What is it that the patient wants? There are times when those, if it's a deep rift, that they won't heal, right? So we do the best that we can. We don't know what it is to die perfectly. What does that mean? No one dies totally comfortable. I have come to believe that there is a place where we need a person, in order to die, a person needs to surrender. We need to surrender ourselves, our life, right? And in order to surrender, we need to feel a sense of peace. That I do have come really to believe. Not everybody is able to get at that place. But, you know, so with families, if there's a desire for together, some families really are amazing how they come together. It's amazing, even if it is just for that time. And sometimes I sit down with a family and, okay, this is what's happening. How are you going to get through the next week? Like, your loved one will likely pass away. That's the expectation, within a few days or so on. How are you going to be family in this week to enable them to die? And then, how are you going to be family for the next while, through the funeral or whatever you decide? And then you do what you want, right? But how can we come, where are our places where we can come together? Sometimes that doesn't happen, but it's amazing what can happen. It is really amazing what can happen. What families find very difficult sometimes is when their loved one is non-responsive, they say, when they're at the end stages of their dying, and yet seemingly holding on for days, and sometimes for a week or even longer. It's the vigil time, I call it, when a lot of family, either they're there a lot or, you know, that sometimes is a time of real healing as well. I remember being with a daughter of a patient and talking with her. I took a lot of opportunity in the course of a week, and this is when her mother was non-responsive, quote-unquote. And she had had a very difficult relationship with her mom. And when I'm visiting and talking with family members, I'm always thinking or aware that the patient is taking something in. I don't know what, but I that's the approach I'm taking, you know. So we're talking, so I'm mindful of that as I talk and the kind of questions I ask. But as we're talking, and through the week, she's shared many things about their relationship, about their mom, And so you come to the point, so what's been beautiful about your relationship, right? And so we get to that point. So all the conflict pieces have been talked about. And then, you know, at the end of the week, I was with her, and the daughter said, you know, I think there's a reason my mother stayed alive this long, because now I'm at peace, right? And she had traveled far in this week, for sure. And you know what? A few hours later, her mother died.